Hi guys, this is Sushant, Kochar, and today we are going to talk about from where you can buy milk, or more precisely from where you can get milk at your home. So I'll discuss ways where you from where you can get milk at your home. So basically, the first one that I would say is own a cow. Now you would say, okay, so you have started with the dumbest thing we could ever hear, own a cow, it is not practically possible. Is this your solution? Is this the solution to buy milk from, so be practical, now, who owns a cow nowadays? Everyone buys from the market. I can hear all those things and I have already thought about them. Now you might also say, if I own a cow, who would do the job of the cow, who would clean the shit of the cow, cow dung, and who would milk the cow twice a day, who has so much time to do all these things, who would take care of feeding the cow, and who would basically, so you would say that who would have so much time in today's busy world to do all that stuff for a cow. Yeah, that is true. Okay, so I'll come to it. But still, I have given thought to all of these things. The first time I heard this, I was like, who would own a cow? But now I'm like, okay, I'll own a cow. It is one of my to-do list. It is one of the tasks in my to-do list. Okay, anyways, I'll come to it. Okay, so if I talk about owning a cow, there can be three stages where you are, three types of cities that where you can be living in. One is you are in village, second is you are in a small to medium sized city, third is that you are in a big city. Now let's say you are in a village. So for a villager, usually villagers have ample space, a lot of space, so they can have they can easily have space for a cow. So they can easily have land for a cow, and villagers usually would not face problem in owning a cow. So I would say, if you're a villager and watching this video and you are not owning a cow and you're buying milk from somewhere else which is not trustworthy, then you own a cow. It is easy for you in a village. Now let's come to small to medium-sized cities. If you talk about small to medium-sized cities, then there can be two cases. If you are a resident in a small or medium-sized city, then you either already own a house or you'll be making one in future. So, in small cities or medium-sized cities, usually people do not live in flats. So, flat is a house in a building. So, there will be a building, there will be 10 or 15 or 20 houses in the building itself. And the land will be common to all the houses and you'll live in a flat. But in usually small or medium cities, people live, people own a land and an individual house. So if you already have a house, try to get a space equivalent to a small room where you can keep a cow, I would say. That is, if you can accommodate, try to accommodate. If you can't, we'll discuss about other options later. If you are planning to make a house in near future, then try to keep space for a cow where you can keep a cow. Now if you say land is too expensive nowadays, it costs lakhs or crores of rupees to buy land, it is even hard for us to get land for ourselves, and you are talking about getting a land for cow with your house. Yeah, so if cost is really a big issue, I would say, okay, let us proceed. We'll try to see what other options we can have. Now, if you're a resident of a big city, if you're a resident of something like Delhi, Bombay, Kolkata, then there can be two ways you're living over there. Perhaps you're living in an individual building's flat, because these metro cities have really congested areas. So people would live, most probably the people would be living in a building rather than owning an individual house, because it is very expensive to own a house over there. So if you are living in an individual building flat, then it might not be easy for you to own a cow. If you're living in a society where there are multiple buildings, there is a garden, there is a boundary of the society, there is a committee of the society, there are even temples, parking space, everything in the society. So you can, a few families of the society can team up and they can ask the committee of the society or the maintenance of the society to get some small space to keep the cows for the society. I think that is a feasible option even in big cities. This is what I could think. If there are any other better options, you can suggest them in comments, or you can directly implement them yourself. You can suggest them in comments, maybe I'll talk about them in my future videos. Okay, so let's say you say, okay, let's say we got some space to keep the cow, but who would take care of the cow? Who would milk the cow twice a day? Who would take care of feeding the cow? And who would clean the dung of the cow and all of those things? See, our ancestors used to do it, at least in India. I'm not sure about other countries, but our ancestors used to do it, and that is not a very old story, 30, 20, 40 years ago, and still a lot of people are doing it in India. So a lot of people are doing it themselves. They are doing everything for the cow themselves, cleaning the dung, and milking the cow, feeding them. They are doing them by themselves, thinking that it is a work of their own home. It is their own work. So they do not think that it is a disrespected work. They think it is their own work, and there is nothing to disrespect in this work. And if you do not want to do it yourself, or you do not have enough time, you can hire someone to do it for you. It is not too expensive to hire someone for this work. So I would say, doing all of this, you might say, if I try to do it myself, let's say I hire someone and that person does not come on Sunday, then I would have to do it myself on Sunday, and who would clean the shit of cow on Sunday? It stinks and all those things. And hiring someone would cost money, and keeping space for cow would cost money. Then I would say, see, if you eat contaminated milk and milk products, you might get a disease, or someone from your family might catch a disease. I'm not saying that they will, but they might. And you do not want yourself or your family members to be suffering, because then you will have a cost of medicine for going to doctors and testing reports, hospitals. You will have to incur those costs, and that is much better than anyone dying because of milk's contamination, I would say. And if someone catches a really bad disease, then smelling cow dung is better than your own body stinking. I'm not saying that would happen to you. I pray to God that it happens to no one, but it can happen to someone. So in my opinion, if you stay down to the ground, that is a key to happiness. More this is equal to more happy. So if you think, oh, I'm an educated individual, I would not do these small works, and I cannot follow any order, I would do whatever I want to, I earn, I'm self-dependent. If you think so, I would say that you would face a lot of problems mentally. You would not be really happy mentally. So more this is more happy. So be down to the ground. Don't think these are cheap works. They are not. They are your own works. They are for your own health. They can help you stay live longer and healthier. Okay. So if we'll talk about this case when you cannot have enough space to keep a cow. We'll talk about this. But let's say you're in a big city. So I would say that you can see an option of relocating to a small city as well. Relocating to your own city. If you have migrated to a big city, you can see the option of relocating to your own city. And it has been happening after and Narendra Modi ji's government came into rule, people in small or medium sized cities have started their businesses, and those businesses have given employments to a lot of people. So now you can migrate back to your own small or medium sized city, and you can own a business or have a job over there and earn decently. Then you have a lot of many more perks. You can live with family. Many people who live outside their own cities do not get enough privilege of living with family. Then usually people migrate to bigger cities. Bigger cities means more fast moving life, more pollution, less health. So as far as I remember, I read a statistic of Delhi, and it was something like, if someone lives his or her whole life in Delhi, then the pollution of Delhi, then just breathing in the pollution of Delhi can reduce the lifespan of the person by 10 to 20 years. You do not want that to happen to yourself. I'm not sure if that statistic is correct or the number is what I remember, but it was something similar, as far as I remember. So you do not want your health to be suffering from pollution. And people migrate to big cities because they think that they would earn a lot, and they do earn a lot in terms of numbers, but expenses in big cities are also a lot. Big cities are expensive, and you will, if you earn a lot in the big cities, then you would spend a lot in the big cities. So your savings would be similar to what you earn in a small city. So if you earn moderate amount in a small city, and then you can save some decent amount, and that is also the case when you go to the big city. You can save really significant amounts in big cities when you earn really significant amounts. So basically what I would say is, think about migrating back to your own small or medium sized city where you have lesser pollution, you have your family, you can own a job or business over there, and you can have lesser income but lesser expenses as well. So similar savings, I would say. Okay, so let's say you would say, oh, I can, I have my job in Delhi, I cannot relocate back to my town. Okay, then let's say we explore the third option. If you cannot own a cow, then try to get the milking of the cow done in front of your eyes. So if you go to buy milk, ask the seller to milk the cow in front of you. Yeah, that happens. That is a very popular trend in my city in Rajasthan, and a lot of people do it even today, and I have done it myself. And around 10, 20 or 30 years back, it was a huge trend in the society. As people started going outside for education, or people started getting busy in mobiles and laptops, the new generation has not been doing so much of this, but still new generation, as well as many of people from the old generation, are doing it. They go in the morning, or morning and evening both, and they go and get the milking of the cow done in front of their eyes. They would check the bucket to see if there is no water initially in the bucket, present in the bucket, and they would see if there is no water in the drum where they gather the milk. So they would initial check there is no water, and they'll get the milking done, and they'll buy the milk. And even there are cases, this is a common case, that someone would talk to the milk seller, and they would deal that, okay, this cow's milk would be mine, I'll come to you in the evening or in the morning, and you will milk this cow and give the milk to me at the very same time. This is a common thing. So it is not practically impossible. It has been, initially it looks like it will be a work for both morning and evening, or even at least once a day. But once you fit it in your routine, you do not even realize it. It becomes your routine. And that is how our previous generations, and even our current generation, is doing it so easily, regularly. In this case, you can check the bucket or the drum, but you cannot see if the seller is injecting the cows with hormones when you are not present over there. Maybe at night, maybe in the morning, whenever. So you can validate everything, but you cannot validate the injection part. Okay, let's say you would say, oh, I do not have enough time to go and see the milking happening in front of me, in front of my eyes, okay? Then try to buy from a person who is a very trustworthy person for you, I would say. If you really have some, if you really know someone who's trustworthy, then try to buy milk from that person, but make sure that you trust the person. And if you, if some seller tries to butter you, oh, this is really great milk, it will give you a lot of cream and all those things. Don't get fooled by buttering, just try to estimate, try to anticipate which seller is a trustworthy seller or not. I would really like to see, to validate by doing a lot of checks if the seller is a trustworthy seller. Now, if you do not, if you cannot find a trustworthy person, now what to do? Then one option that is left is that buy open milk from a local seller or get it delivered at your home, which is perhaps what you have been already doing. That is the option left after this. That is, at least that is what I can do. And if you are in a really big city and there are no local sellers of open milk, then have to buy packaged milk. That is, I can say, is the last option. But in both of these two options, where you buy open milk from local seller or packaged milk, there is a trade-off. So you can think it this way. You, this is your call if you want to buy it or not, but you can think it this way. Either you want, either you can think that, okay, so there are some minor harmful effects of milk, this contaminated milk, but I would still drink it because there are health benefits of milk according to Ayurveda. Okay, that is one thought process. And you can also think that there are health benefits of milk as per Ayurveda, but contamination of these milks is even more harmful, so I would not drink milk which is not from a trustworthy source for myself. So that is your call, whichever way you want to go. Okay, now after all this, if you say who would do all this, who does have time to do so much in this busy routine, then I would say, see, try to do it for yourself. Try to do, if you are not trying to do it for yourself, try to do it for your old mother and father, or your young children, or your wife or husband, or your brother or sister. Try to do it for your family, because if you're bringing contaminated milk to your home or contaminated milk products to your home, then you're not just harming your health, you're harming your family's health, your old age mother, father, who are more sensitive to contaminated food, your young children who are in a growing age, who if they contaminated food products would suffer in later in their lives, can suffer later in their lives. You do not want to harm your family's health, even if you do not care about yours, I would say. Now, milk and milk products form a really big part of our daily lives, daily food. So they are very important in our lives. So if you say, oh no, I'm lazy, I will not own a cow, I will not go to get the milking done in front of my eyes, I do not have enough time to do all this. If you're lazy, or you think that owning a cow can be expensive, or hiring someone to take care of the cow can be expensive. So let me tell you one thing first, that owning a cow would not be expensive. Even if you hire a person who comes in the day, in the morning and the evening to milk the cow and feed her, it will not be expensive, because if you go out in the market and try to buy milk which is milked in front of your eyes, the pure milk, it costs around 40 rupees. Sometimes it goes to 50 or 50 plus in the peak summer season. But the people usually who deliver at your home deliver it at a cost of 28 rupees or so, or 30 rupees. They make their profit in 28 rupees. They get the cost of petrol that they are using in their motorcycles. They cover that cost also. So that happens because they many times they would take out the cream and mix water in the milk. So basically they'll sell cream apart from the milk and they'll add water, so the quantity of the milk increases. So that is how they make profits. So if you buy pure milk, it would cost you around 40 rupees. And you can make all the milk products from it, milk, curd, ghee, butter, buttermilk, and chhena or paneer. So you can make all the milk products from it. So if you try to find all the costs that you incur in buying all the milk products from the market, that cost would be similar to owning a cow with a guarantee that the cow is not giving you contaminated milk because you are not injecting the cow or harming the cow in any other way. So that is what I would say, that the cost would be similar even if you hire someone. Hiring someone for milking the cow is not that costly. So even if you hire someone, it would not be that costly. The cost would be similar. Your daily milk or milk products from the market would cost similar to owning a cow and feeding it together. Okay. So if you're lazy, thinking who would do all this, then, and if you think there is a lot of cost involved, then I would say that being lazy now can make you or your family suffer in later phases of their lives when they have been drinking contaminated milk for a long time, and it can lead to diseases or maybe death. There is not so many scientific researches on the same giving strong proofs about something, but definitely unnatural things would lead to harmful health effects. And there, if you think there is a lot of cost involved in owning the cow, you have to find the space and then you have to keep someone to milk the cow, and then you have to clean the place where the cow stays, and then you have to feed the cow. If you think there is a lot of cost, then first of all, this cost is almost equivalent to the cost of your, the monthly cost of your milk or milk products. But still, if you think there is a lot of cost, then this cost would be lesser than the medical cost that you would incur if you get it, if you or someone from your family catches a disease. So you would have to go get the test done, the reports, the doctor's visits, maybe sometimes hospitalization and all those costs, medicines, you would not want, and then suffering on the body or and the mental suffering when you see someone beloved of yours suffering. So I'm not saying that that would happen to you or your family. I would pray that that doesn't happen to anyone in the world, but it can happen to someone. So we would not want to eat unnatural things. We would not want to eat contaminated products. We would want to eat pure products. Now if you have a question that have you ever milked the cow in front of your eyes? As soon as I realized that this milk, there are so many problems with the, today's milk, then I started buying the milk which was being milked in front of my eyes. I used to go once in a day in the evening, but someone can go twice a day if one wants. And also, if you have this question that, okay, you have given us lecture to own a cow, do you own a cow? Currently, I do not own a cow, but I have plans to own a cow in near future. And I'm not faking, I have plans to own a cow in near future. I am, and I'm all okay if I have to clean the cow shit, cow dung, or if I have to milk the cow, if I have to feed the cow, I'm all okay with it. I don't think that it is a cheap work or it is a work which is disrespectful. It is your own housework, it is your work, it is work for your and your family's health. And it is also a good deed when you are taking care of cow, when you are doing seva for the cow. So that is my perspective. At the end of this video, I would like to say that what I was not trying to say that you or any one of your family or me or anyone of my family would catch a disease. What I'm trying to say is that someone might, by eating contaminated products, someone might catch a disease. Although I do not want anyone to catch a disease on this earth or even outside, and I pray that no one catches a disease, because no one catches a disease even if that person is my enemy. But still, we cannot be just relying on the prayers. We have to put some effort from our own side. That is what I would say. If you think that this information is useful for anyone, you can share it with them. You can also like and comment. I'll see you in the next video.